Hi, and welcome to the ninth part of the Simple Character Control series. Today, we are adding the ability to run, or sprint, where the speed is gradually increasing or decreasing. In Unity, open up the input actions. Create a new action called sprint. Leave the action type as button and set the binding to whatever you choose to sprint with. I'll go with the left shift key. Save the asset and open up the play controller script. Here, below everything else, start by creating a new struct called movement. This will contain variables related to movement, but let's start by adding public bool is sprinting. We won't need to see this, so let's hide it with hide in inspector. Right above this, type serializable within square brackets. Scroll up and, within square brackets, type serialize field followed by private movement and simply call it movement. Below our jump method down here, create a new one called sprint. Public void sprint with input action.callbackContext followed by context within the parentheses. Here, we can type movement.isSprinting equals context.started or context.performed. As you might remember, the context contains three states of this action that we can listen to: started, performed, and cancelled. So, what this means is that the isSprinting boolean is true when the action has started, the key being pushed down, or when it is being performed, the key being held down. If not, meaning that it is cancelled, the boolean is set back to false. Now, while not necessary, I'd say that it's a good habit to always test your code and start early. So, in the update method, log the isSprinting variable and jump back into Unity. Find the player input object in the hierarchy and choose events and gameplay in the player input component. Here, find your new sprint event, click on the plus symbol and drag your character object into the object field. And for its function, choose player controller and up here you'll find your newly created sprint method. Hit play and have a look at the console. It should immediately print out false, and when you press down the sprint key, it is now printing true. All good, let's have a look at how to actually make the character sprint. Back in the player controller script, remove the debug log in the update method. Scroll down to the movement struct and let's add a few new ones. Public float speed, public float multiplier, and public float acceleration. And finally, add a private float called current speed, which we can also hide in the inspector. Find the apply movement method and let's set the target speed. Var target speed equals movement.isSprinting. And if we are sprinting, we're setting the target speed to movement.speed multiplied by the multiplier, and else just the speed. Now let's set the current speed. Movement.currentSpeed equals mathf.moveTowards. Where the first parameter is movement.currentSpeed, the second one is target speed, and the third one is movement.acceleration multiplied by time.deltaTime. And finally, on the next row, update speed to movement.currentSpeed. And you know what? That's it! Jump back into Unity and start running! Choose the character in the hierarchy and I'll set the speed to 5 and the multiplier to 2. And the acceleration to 20. These are values you should play around with to find what works for your game. Hit play and start moving around. Hit the sprint key and you'll see that the character is now running. And the change isn't instant, but rather gradually making the character faster. Have a look at my GitHub page where the project is now updated, and if you have any questions, let me know down in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.